YouTube has some secrets that many people ask, so I thought I'd put them together in this video. First of all, did you know that YouTube has secret stats for nerds? I am a self-confessed weird facts and stats nerd, and there's a very special feature just for me and for you hidden in YouTube. The Stats for Nerd feature will give you frame rates, codec rates, sizing, those kind of things, and it's all hidden in plain sight in the desktop version of YouTube's browser functionality. Trust me, that's not easy to say. I fluffed that up in that video two or three times. But if you're a statsy nerd like me, I'm gonna show you how you can find it.
Okay, so first of all, you need to go to a video that you'd like to watch. Now, in this case, I'm using one of my own videos as an example, but it will work on any desktop video. You hover over the main body of the video, and on desktop, you right click. As you scroll down, you'll see Stats for Nerds. When you turn it on, this little box shows up, in which it shows you video ID, viewport, in which it's the size thereof, current versus optimal resolution, the frame rate it happens to be in, the volume, whether it's normalized, how loud it happens to be, how much it is addressed, the codecs that it is currently using, the host, the connection speed, the network activity, the buffer health, and how many frames are dropped while streaming. Now, all of these may not be your bag, but if you are hunting for these kind of things just for understanding, if you're an analytics nerd, if you're a stats nerd, there's all the facts that you'll have and easily available at your fingertips. Now, to turn it off, simply click the little X.
Shh, the video is private, but you can share it with friends.
Ever wanted to upload a YouTube video and then share it with a friend to get their critique, their opinion, their feedback before it went public? Before now, you'd have to set it to unlisted and then hope that it didn't leak out somehow. Because if you set it unlisted and share out that link and then that link gets to somebody else, other people can still see it. If it's still sat in a playlist, for example. Today, I'm gonna show you how you can upload a video, it be completely private, and you share it with as many people as you want, but only those people can access using their Google account.
Okay, so the first thing you need to do is go to a video which is private or in draft, right? So this is one of my clients' accounts. What I'm going to do is go to a draft video here, click the little pencil. It will show you the title, the descriptions, and this is your just general draft loadout. You'll see visibility up here and you'll see a few options. Save or publish in private mode. This means that only you can see the video. Unlisted, this is people who you share the link with, but it's not published to your general wider subscriber base. Public, this is what you do when you're publishing a video, and you can set it as an instant premiere, which is those mini live stream things of a pre-recorded video. Now we're going to click share privately, and it says here, you can invite others to view your private video by entering in their email address below. Invitees must sign into a Google account to view the private video. So I'm going to invite myself to view this video. I'm going to click notify via email and click done. You will now see here it says privately shared with Alan at alanspicer.com. Save video to share. So I click save. And now if I was to go back in by clicking the little pencil here and go into the visibility on the right hand side, you'll see once again the same options. Private, unlisted, public. It says that I privately shared with that specific email address. I can edit it, I can remove me, or I can add more. I then receive an email that looks like this. So that account has shared a video with you. It will show you the video, right? I can click on that video. It now loads, even though it is private, and I can see the video itself.
If you don't want to show your face or somebody else's face in the video for that matter, you can blur it. In fact, you can blur faces, track faces, blur objects. So should you need to hide things, should you be doing an unboxing and accidentally have your address, or you don't have permission of random people that walk through your videos, you can blur their faces and not worry about losing footage. It's quite easy to do, so why don't we go to the computer.
Okay, so this is the new YouTube Studio. On the left hand side, there's a tab that says videos, and it will load you into this screen. This is where it lists all of your video content. No doubt you've seen it before. In this case, we're going to use this one as a dummy. So you click the title. This is where you'd normally add your title, your descriptions, your tags, your thumbnails, you add it to playlists, but we're focusing on the editor. It's a nice new black layout. And if we're adding blur, we go down to the bottom scroll the little bar down and you'll see add blur. At this point you may be warned that you need to update your flash. That's perfectly fine, but you jump to what looks like a little bit of classic mode. Now, you're blurring either faces or custom blurring. If you're blurring faces, it will be specific faces. If you're choosing to track something that's moving across the screen, you'll use the custom blurring. For custom blurring, you simply click edit. You go to the point where you want to blur something. So let's jump to the middle of the video and then you click pause. Then you select something in the video that you wish to blur. So let's say I want to blur out this section of the video. So for example, I accidentally put an address there, for example. I can then highlight that area. It will then scan through the video so it then knows that what it is blurring before and what it's blurring after. Once it's been done, you'll see that it pops up here. Lock or unlock. You can lock it so it doesn't move anywhere. And then there you go, that's your little custom square done. So once again, if you've accidentally put your address on the screen or a phone number, you can use the custom blur tool. So here you can see the square has been blurred. It locks it as well, so it will track it. No matter how I zoom in and zoom out, it will track that specific square. There you go. So I've jumped around a bit there, but it still stayed locked on that square. If you're using blur faces, click edit. It will then process your video. It will have a look. It will find faces for you. It can take a little bit of time, so you can click process and then go elsewhere. So after it's processed a little while, it identifies the faces in the videos, and it also tells you the timeline of those faces in that video. So if I want to blur my face, I select me. It then goes through the video and applies a blur to my face. Look at that. It's like a giant thumb smear print. And if you click play, you'll see what it does. It traces and tracks my face. Now, it's like I'm Christian Cage in the WWE. If you get that reference, I love you. It finds you, it tracks your face, and it makes sure that you can be removed. Now, as you saw, there was parts in the intro where it kind of blurs indiscriminately. It goes over graphics and stuff, so it's not perfect. But if you want a quick removal of someone from your video, then there you go. That's how you add your very own custom blur and blur out individual faces. You click save. And you are done.
Looking to upload a YouTube video from your mobile phone? Here is a super high quality secret hack. So you want to record videos on your phone and upload them to YouTube. For whatever reason, every time you upload to YouTube, it seems to be capped. It doesn't seem to upload at the resolution that you've decided that it should be. You want to upload your video in the highest quality. There's a few things for you to look at. One, make sure you're recording in the highest quality. I've got an iPhone SE 2nd edition. If I'm recording on my phone and I really want the footage to stand out, then I'll go for 4K. Now, I have got a deep dive video on how you can set your phone on 4K, and even on slow-mo, I'll put them in the iCard up here. But very quickly, you go to Settings, Camera, click on the record video settings, and then you can choose what best suits you. If you've got a lot of space on your phone and you've maybe got control of the environment you're recording in, maybe try 4K. Whether it's at 24 or 30 frames per second for talking head, that's perfectly fine. But if you want a little bit of extra leeway where you might want to slow the footage down, then try 60 frames per second, in which it gives you a little bit more wiggle room. Now, the higher quality video means more space taking up on your phone, but it can lead to a better quality video. Two, consider the sound of your phone. If you're recording from your camera, it's perfectly fine. I've recorded many videos just using my phone, but you might want to step it up a notch. You might either want to record external sound and then sync it to your phone, use a microphone that you can connect to your phone. You can even get a lavalier mic now that can plug into the Thunderbolt port at the bottom of your phone. That way you're not just relying on the audio quality of your phone, and it gives you, once again, the best quality video matched with the best quality sound. Three, now I render all of my videos using my laptop. I'm pointing down there because it's there. But there are tools out there that can help you render it out on your phone, like KineMaster or iMovie. But the most important thing, no matter what you are rendering out on, is that you go for the highest quality that you can possibly render out on. What I mean is, if you've got 4K footage, render it out in 4K. But if you're going for 1080p, match the quality of your footage. Whether it's 60 frames per second, 30 frames per second, 24 frames per second, I honestly can't tell the difference between 30 and 60 by the human eye. And the only time it truly matters is if you're doing something sporty, action-y, that kind of thing. So you've got the best quality video with the best quality audio, and you've rendered it out to the best of its actual abilities using your laptop or your phone. Now you need to upload it. Keeping to the theme that you're doing it with your phone, I'm going to upload it using the YouTube app. But there is one thing that you should really pay attention to. YouTube has this little thing that throttles the quality of your video. Whether you're directly editing it on your phone, or whether you've edited it, moved it onto your phone, and then want to upload it at a later date, for idiots like me, there is an upload quality feature. So, go to the YouTube app. Click on your avatar in the top right-hand corner and click settings. Scroll all the way down to the bottom and there's a hidden thing in the uploads box saying upload quality. You'll see that mine's defaulted to 1080p rather than full quality. If you choose full quality, it will use the original file, it will upload the original file, and therefore it gives YouTube the best quality video for YouTube to render with its own codecs and then work its magic. Rather than you've done all of the hard work of editing it in 4K and uploading and making great, fantastic audio and fantastic video, and then you've uploaded the 4K footage and they've rescaled it and re-rendered it into 1080p because your phone said so. But now you're the master of your own destiny and you can pick your own settings. If you need help with settings for 4K or slow-mo, there's a playlist here. Subscribe for more YouTube mobile tips and YouTube tutorials.